circumstances not being need to address things. So we want to prioritise that as a piece of work. So if that just helps, it just adds a little bit more. I know it's not directly answering Councillor Kelly's question on this particular matter. I think the solicitor's done that, but I just wanted to add in that for committee's information.
Cheers.
Well, I mean,
acceptable for a development.
development consisting of a HMO of 10 single-bedroom units as indicated on the submitted plans, it is necessary to restrict the number of occupiers to no more than 10 persons to make that development acceptable. So what you're saying is there should be a condition that there should be no more than 10 occupants on the building. Now, this is an issue that has been discussed previously at committee, and I recall from a previous appeal, I think it was the one in New Brighton, where the inspector clearly said that such a condition, it was not reasonable to expect the council to enforce such a condition. And I think Councillor Foulkes made the same point at a previous debate that we had on one of these HMOs. I'm just pointing that out. The two inspectors have said two entirely contradictory things. And I fully support what Stuart is trying to do here. I think we should be pressing this, because otherwise we're really undermining all the achievements we've made, the progress we've made on this issue to date.
I think the planning inspector is aware of these contradictory decisions that are being made by planning inspectors, and there are steps that they are taking internally to try and get more coherence between the decisions. But the difficulty from the authority's perspective is that, as I say, the challenge of judicial review would have to prove that the decision of that inspector was not one that any other inspector could have taken. And I think, given the disparity between decisions, it's hard to prove that decision was completely But as I say, I will take further advice from council on that point, and we'll consider it further.
I'm happy to seek advice. What I'm not happy is leaving council down endorsed by that on the whim of members who are members and all fire experts. So yeah, we have to be remember where we are requesting an investigation of whether we've got about I think David's made a point the ability to deflect these applications is in our own hands with our own policy that we develop. And that's the thing that should we are making it ad hoc, aren't we, at this committee, on the hoof, whatever one calls it. And it's that policy that we should expedite to give us the backing to actually use our local reasons to refuse it. So I agree, and it's helpful to move to the next stage. I delegated the three party spokespersons to see what the result of council's advice is.
Okay, I think the other thing that David didn't mention was that we obviously had this raised in the previous planning meeting was regarding the cumulative impact of HMOs as well. So that's an area that I have to take into consideration. Okay, Ian,
just
want to say
this. I don't want it to drift into the realms of this and I've said that. So for this to succeed, and you need to pinpoint a particular point where the inspector has erred in law. So it's not, I don't agree what he said there, I agree to that extent. And I think I may have pinpointed you, Steve, we need to take, I'd like, if we've got a better than even chance of success, then I honestly think that we should press it. And I'm conscious of where the delegation lies, that's why I asked the question the way that I did, that clearly would be a resource issue. It lies with the head of law, potentially with the leader of the council, in terms of the political decision. As long as I'm clear what's happening, given that it's been aired at this meeting, the officer, David Warren, the senior officer, and senior as the chief legal officer for this committee, will be able to go away to repair what people have said, and even potentially do anything.
Okay, well, I think Cecilia said that she's happy to say to the
wife.
Said and agreed. Are we happy to approve to note these planning appeals decided upon? Okay, I'd just like to mention to Andre or B to planning committee that the site visits that we said we would do will be on the 15th of August at 10 a.m. and we'll have the previous for okay, we have agenda item 15, which is Thornton Manor, and it's also an item from the late list. And David, I think you're going to speak to this item.
Yes.
Straight to recommendation without debate.